Dear friends, good evening to all. I'm Dr. Madhavi Lata, working in Department of Farm Forestry, Acharya N.G. Ranga Agriculture University. So in our Department of Farm Forestry, we have actually about 12 to 13 acres under different agroforestry systems. We have the trees like Amla, Terminalia, and then Featherbia, Arbida, Neem, etc. We have been establishing different blocks, and we are conducting the research in those tree-based cropping systems. So my topic today is economic viability of medicinal plants cultivation in tree-based intercropping systems under dryland conditions. So as we all know, in the arid and the semi-arid regions, the main constraint is the erratic rainfall and also the fragile environment leading to low soil fertility. So under such a situation, what is the best option we can provide to the farmer so that he can get more economic returns? So under such a system, agroforestry is a very good option, and under that you have different systems. Among them, agri-silviculture, that is growing the agricultural crops in between the trees, is a viable method which will give the more economic returns to the farmer. And if we see, coming to the medicinal plants, they are the gifts of nature to the human beings. And as we know, due to the side effects by using the drugs continuously, allopathy medicines, we are facing so many problems. So instead of that, by using the medicinal plants, we can protect at least our health. So what we have done is, we have certain medicinal and aromatic plants which are shade loving. So what are the different medicinal plants which can be grown under the trees, which are more viable to the farmer? So we have conducted a study here. We have taken two tree crops, that is Amla and Terminalia. Under that, we have taken two medicinal plants, Andrographis and Ashwagandha. So as we all know, Andrographis paniculata, it is known as Kalmei, and it is mostly used in the liver disorders, malaria and blood purification. And Andrographolide is the main content which is responsible for the medicinal property in this. Apart from this, we had also tested another crop, that is Ashwagandha, that is Vithenia somnifera, in which the roots are of the medicinal value. And it is used for the TB, respiratory diseases, rheumatism, and also in obesity, to reduce obesity. So we have taken up these two trials simultaneously under Amla and Terminalia. We know that Amla tree, it has sparse vegetation, and Terminalia has broadly, so the shading is more in Terminalia compared to Amla. So we had two experiments. First experiment is study of Ashwagandha having different main plots and subplots. In the main plots, have taken up three cropping situations wherein Ashwagandha was sown under Amla, Ashwagandha was sown under Terminalia, and it was compared to the sole crop wherein there was no shading of the trees. And again under that, we had different subplots with integrated nutrient management treatments. So we had taken the control, and then we took urea alone, only inorganic fertilizer applied, and then we had another treatment with fomite manure, another treatment with vermicompost, and again fomite manure and vermicompost in combination with urea. We wanted to see which is the best INM treatment which will increase the yield of the medicinal plant as well as improve the soil fertility. So similarly, experiment 2 was also conducted on the same lines, but the crop was different, that is Andrographis was studied here. So if you see, both Andrographis and Ashwagandha were grown under Terminalia, and this is the Andrographis, and that is Ashwagandha crop grown under Amla and Terminalia. This is under Terminalia, that is broadleaf weeds having more shading effect onto the crop. You can see in the picture that Ashwagandha crop couldn't come up well, but Andrographis has come up very well. Similarly, Ashwagandha intercropped in Amla, wherein it could not sustain more shade. But Andrographis, it has come up well compared to the sole cropping. There was no reduction in the yield under the trees as well as the sole in Andrographis. And coming to the economic yield, as we all know, in Andrographis, the economic yield is the herbage yield, and in Ashwagandha, the root yield is important. So when we compare the three systems, that is intercropping in Amla, Terminalia, compared to the sole cropping, obviously we get high yields in sole cropping. But here it was found that Andrographis gave similar yields. in sole crop compared to that of amla and andrographis. But that was not the case in ashwagandha. If you come to ashwagandha, as I told you, it could not sustain shade and there was not good growth under the shade. As a result, the sole crop yield was more compared to intercropping in amla or in terminalia. So safely we can say that andrographis can be successfully grown under the tree combinations. Next, we have studied the economic fruit yields also in amla and terminalia. However, the yields were highest in terminalia because of the higher fruit yield cost and also the higher fruit yield in terminalia compared to amla. And what the farmer is finally interested is the net returns is getting from the total system, that is the tree plus cropping system. So the farmers are with the misconception that trees, they give the returns for a longer duration, so they are not going for the agroforestry. But from this experiment, you can clearly find out that the gross return 1.62. However, in ashwagandha, the yields were very less compared to that of the andrographis, as it couldn't come up well under the shade. So this is the main research finding, and what the farmers are asking, sir, mostly under the orchards, they are interested to grow the medicinal plants under the shade. So we can safely recommend andrographis, which can be grown under the shade without any reduction in the yield. So in the present context of this climate change also, we can conduct the different studies on carbon sequestration also, and also how the soil fertility is being improved with the crops like medicinal plants. And so I request that, because this is a study, is the first under tree crop situations, if we continue the further studies with the different medicinal crops combinations, we can give good findings to the farmers, which will improve their economic standard of living. Thank you.